Woods, rock stars called on our next guest not to get him on stage but to take their pictures. That's because Tony Mott is one of the best photographers in the business and he's here with us on the couch, Studio 10. Yeah. Hi. 30 years of taking rock music photos, amazing. And you got your big break when you worked with the Divinals.
Yeah, I'm a French chef by trade and
Are
I used
you?
To work in King's Cross. And I used to, in the early 80s, finish work about 11 o'clock at night. And then go out, and my passion was music and also photography. And then one night, I happened upon Chrissy Amphlett and the Divinals, and I thought, God, that must be really difficult to photograph. And I started practicing, and that's the very first photo I ever saw.
That is a great photo.
But she's one of the great front people.
She's not one of the greatest. Right. She is, in my humble opinion, the greatest female performer I've ever witnessed. And I've photographed Madonna, Rihanna, everybody.
Why? What did she
say? Good.
Yeah.
Unpredictability, screaming banshee. Even if you didn't like the music, she would mesmerise you on stage. I was often in fear of my safety, her safety, and definitely the audience's safety.
And she's a bit frightening too, wasn't she?
She regarded herself as a friend of mine. I remember her once saying, "Oh, we're really close friends." But even after all those years, she still intimidated the hell out of me.
And I was reading your bio. I want to get onto the stage later, but I was reading your bio. Is it true that the Divinals told you that your name was on the door? Tell us that story.
Well, first photo, they paid me $20 and they said, "Oh, and your name's on the door." And I went, "Oh, great, that's fantastic." And about a month later, the manager said, "You know your name's on the door." And I went, "Yeah," thinking there was some door somewhere where they scribbled everyone's up. I continued to pay because I was so green, I had no idea what it meant.
Oh, that's sweet.
So there's some door somewhere with my name on it.
Absolutely.
Talk about the Stones. You've toured with the Rolling Stones. That picture of Mick Jagger we saw is one of the most iconic images of all time.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, the first time I toured with the Stones, I thought I'd just be put in the pit and I'd just take photos and that'd be the end of it. But in actual fact, they're an amazingly generous band. And I immediately was taken into the dressing room and introduced to everybody. And I had to remain sort of cool and go, they sort of said, "Hi, this is Tony Mott, he's going to take the photos." But internally, I was going, Oh my God, it's the Rolling Stones. But externally, I was going, "Yeah, I'm the photographer." And they were they really are the greatest rock and roll band in the world. They're the yin and yang. Mick Jagger does 25 to 30 kilometres on stage. Wow. Keith does about 2 yards.
Right. and do you have to be that cool persona? Like, you can't be a fan with them,
no,
can you?
No, you can't be a fan with anybody.
No.
Mick Jagger once gave me some great advice and said, always treat rock stars like ordinary people and ordinary people like rock stars. Great advice.
Interesting. Yeah. Johnny Rotten?
Johnny Rotten.
I mean, you know, like...
Johnny Rotten's completely different. It's best to keep at least 10 yards distance when photographing him. But you know, a great character. The great thing about all rock photographers is everyone's a character, and my job was always to just capture their character, which is great.
Johnny Rotten had that persona of just being a mad bastard, frankly. Was he like that in real life?
He really is the mad bastard he portrays. I think that's right. I don't think he acts. I think it's all real.
I suspect it.
What about Michael Hutchins? What was he like to work with?
Michael Hutchins was an unbelievably charming man and really, really easy to photograph. This particular image was taken, ended up on the cover of Rolling Stone just after his death. And I've always, when everyone asks me about Michael Hutchins, I always say he must have been really, really charming. At his funeral, six ladies travelled halfway around the world to be at his funeral who were exes. That's charming.
Yeah.
In a weird way.
Yeah, no, he's amazing. I think all his exes were friends with each other,
which is a
feat that I certainly can't accomplish. Now, forget about that. How about these names? Madonna, Paul McCartney, Michael Jackson, Kylie Minogue. These are all people you've photographed and had relationships with. How do you get them to look their best? Are they very demanding over what they look like? Are they vain?
I'm actually not always trying to make them look like their best. It's really getting the persona and the character. Paul McCartney was... I mean, I've got a huge advantage over most photographers in so much as these people are famous to start with. So people see the image and go, "Oh, my God, it's Paul McCartney." So you're one up to start with. And then you're just trying to get the character. The live shots are very easy from the point of view is I'm just capturing them in their natural environment, but I've got no control over a crowds, the lighting, whatever. But when I'm doing sessions with them, contrary to popular belief, a lot of musicians are quite uncomfortable in front of a camera. So I'm trying to make them comfortable in whatever way I can.
What are you trying to get out of them? What's the
X factor? I'm trying to get some sort of image that portrays what they do musically. So the easy ones are people like Marilyn Manson. The character is all there in front of you. It's just a doddle. But then you get Sarah McLachlan. Who's not so easy, who's really uncomfortable in front of a camera. So I'm trying to befriend her. I spent probably a week with her in advance on a tour, just, you know, becoming sort of just chatting.
I think we had that photo, actually, to show you.
That's actually taking... I joked with her for a couple of weeks that I was going to photograph her in a toilet, a la Motorhead, which she found most amusing. That is a toilet. That's the Butterfly Room in the State Theatre, which could well be one of the most ornate toilets on the planet.
That's in New South Wales, in Sydney.
In Sydney, I shot the whole album. That's the afterglow, and it was shot in shot in Sydney and Melbourne.
Yeah. And are you trying to represent her as a musician or her as a human and a normal person?
Somewhere between the two, but number one, I listen to her music and her songwriting, and particularly someone like Sarah McLachlan, because her music and her lyrics are really important. So eventually I'm trying to, capture her soul, for the want of a better word, and just trying to capture something that is really her. And really, without actually having that week in advance of getting some sort of rapport with each other, I wouldn't have got it. She was very uncomfortable.
So what, looking uncomfortable, what would she have looked like for those, if you just on the first morning?
I point
morning?
The camera and she immediately goes...
Yeah. Oh, yeah, right. But isn't then that a photo as well?
Yeah. That's a good photo as well. There's nothing wrong with that as well, but I'm also... eye contact's fairly important. Yeah. It really is fairly important for the image to come out. And there's nothing wrong with being shy and uncomfortable in front of a camera. It's just I'm just also trying to capture, the essence of their music. Mm. And sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't.
You draw so much out of people, as we've seen from your photos. Is there anything that's off limits when you're on tour with band members? Because I'm sure you've seen some pretty dicey stuff backstage.
Not now, Tony. I'm snorting a line of coke.
Yeah, those sort of things are what goes... The old cliche of what goes on tour stays on tour. The reality is, if I did a naughty on any of them, and certainly with the Rolling Stones, I was approached by certain unscrupulous journalists from Fleet Street, and I could probably have made a bit of money out of it, but I'd never tour with the Rolling Stones again.
That's right.
So, and ultimately, I wouldn't... It's not my thing. I don't want to do a dirty.
It's got you, Jason.
I want to work with them next week.
And effectively now, you're as much a rock dog as any of them, aren't you? I mean, really.
Yes.
Dog or god?
Rock dog.
You actually look a bit like a Rolling Stone.
Oh, no, I can do...
You're better Ronnie Wood.
I can do Ronnie Wood anytime you like. That's not a problem.
You were just enjoying the talk to Tony. Welcome back anytime. Tony's book, A to Z of Rock and Roll Photography, is out now, and you can find out about it on his website, tonymott.com. And you can see a special exhibition of Tony's photos at the State Library of New South Wales. Great book, fantastic photos, wonderful stories. Thanks for coming
in. Thank you for taking this one with me. Thank you very much.
There's one song.